Welcome to Hushed Voices. I'm your host, Roshni Suparna Divakar. Hi and welcome to Season 2 of Hushed Voices. I'm very excited to share a new set of stories with you. We're also collaborating with Trisha Bose, a Delhi-based illustrator, for the artwork this season. I'm mixing things up a little now, with some stories being split into two episodes. Most of the stories this season are open source and are available online. Let me jump right in. Today's story is titled The Farmer and the Moneylender. It was written by Joseph Jacobs, a British folklorist who was the editor of Folklore, a journal from England's Folklore Society. He began collecting and documenting English and Celtic folklore in the late 19th century. This story was taken from his collection of Indian folktales titled Indian Fairy Tales, first published in 1910. This is The Farmer and the Moneylender. There was once a farmer who suffered much at the hands of a moneylender. Good harvests or bad, the farmer was always poor, and the moneylender rich. At last, when he had nothing left, the farmer went to the moneylender's house and said, "You can't squeeze water from a stone, and as you have nothing to get from me anymore, you might tell me the secret of becoming rich." "My friend," returned the moneylender piously, "riches come from Ram. Ask him." "Thank you, I will," replied the simple farmer. So he prepared 3 rice cakes to last him on the journey and set out to find Ram. First he met a Brahmin, and to him he gave a cake, asking him to point out the road to Ram. But the Brahmin only took the cake and went on his way without a word. Next the farmer met a devotee, and to him he gave a cake, without receiving any help in return. At last, he came upon a poor man sitting under a tree, and finding out he was hungry, the kind farmer gave him his last cake, and sitting down to rest beside him, entered into a conversation. "And where are you going?" asked the poor man. "Oh, I have a long journey before me, for I am going to find Ram," replied the farmer. "I don't suppose you could tell me which way to go." "Perhaps I can," said the poor man, smiling. "For I am Ram. What do you want of me?" Then the farmer told the whole story, and Ram, taking pity on him, gave him a conch shell and showed him how to blow it in a particular way, saying, "Remember, whatever you wish for, you have only to blow the conch that way, and your wish will be fulfilled. Only have a care of that moneylender, for even magic is not proof against their wiles." The farmer went back to his village rejoicing. In fact, the moneylender noticed his high spirits at once and said to himself, "Some good fortune must have befallen the stupid fellow to make him hold his head so jauntily." Therefore, he went over to the simple farmer's house and congratulated him on his good fortune in such cunning words, pretending to have heard all about it, that before long, the farmer found himself telling the whole story, all except the secret of blowing the conch, for with all his simplicity, the farmer was not quite such a fool as that. Nevertheless, the moneylender determined to have the conch by hook or by crook, and as he was villain enough not to stick at trifles, he waited for a favorable opportunity and stole the conch. But after nearly bursting himself with blowing the conch in every conceivable way, he was obliged to give up the secret as a bad job. However, being determined to succeed, he went back to the farmer and said coolly, "Look here, I've got your conch, but I can't use it. You haven't got it, so it's clear you can't use it either. Business is at a standstill unless we make a bargain. Now, I promise to give you back your conch and never to interfere with your using it, on one condition, which is this: whatever you get from it, I am to get double." "Never!" cried the farmer. "That would be the old business all over again." "Not at all," replied the wily moneylender. "You will have your share. Now, don't be a dog in the manger, For if you get all you want, what can it matter to you if I am rich or poor? At last, though it went solely against the grain to be of any benefit to a moneylender, the farmer was forced to yield. And from that time, no matter what he gained by the power of the conch, the moneylender gained double. And the knowledge of this preyed upon the farmer's mind day and night, so that he had no satisfaction out of anything. At last, there came a very dry season. Then he blew the conch and wished for a well to water them. And lo, there was the well, but the moneylender had two beautiful new wells. This was too much for any farmer to stand, and our friend brooded over it and brooded over it, till at last a bright idea came to his mind. He seized the conch, blew it loudly, and cried out, "O Ram, I wish to be blind of one eye." And so he was, and in a twinkling, the moneylender, of course, was blind of both, and in trying to steer his way between the two new wells, fell into one and was drowned. Now, this true story shows that a farmer once got the better of a moneylender, but only by losing one of his eyes. And that is the end of the first episode of season 2 of Hushed Voices. I hope you liked the story. As always, you can find us on YouTube, SoundCloud, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I've shared the links in the description panel below. Thank you for listening.